What is Creative Commons? Why Creative Commons? Where can we get Creative Commons materials? When should we be using Creative Commons? And how could we actually contribute also to the world of Creative Commons? Copyright means if you use it, you need to get their approval. In public domain, you don't need the approval. So in between, now, that's where we come in, with something called Creative Commons. The philosophy behind actually Creative Commons, I created this particular graphic to show, you know, that giving, but yet not giving away. If you were a candle, you're a burning candle, and the other candles come, you know, and you just light them up, you are giving them light, but you are not giving away your light. It's still with you. So that is the principle actually of Creative Commons, okay? Your material, you share it, but it still belongs to you. It's still with you, okay? That is the principle behind it. And actually, that is what education is all about, and that is why we are all academic here in the university, okay? We are here to actually light up many more with respect to our experience and expertise. You can, of course, choose to keep it to yourself, okay? Not sharing it. And that is where many a times, you know, many of our materials that we publish in the journal, in high impact factor journals, and others want to access it, no, they cannot be lighted up, okay? There's a control over there. They're not sharing it. So, unless you pay for it. So this is where, in 2012, UNESCO actually came up with a declaration. And it says this in the final one, the declaration calls on government worldwide to openly license publicly funded educational materials for public use. Which means, legally speaking, actually all our research work, you like it or not, are funded by public money. Malaysian, you know, we've been toiling out there, we are using their money to run our research. But at the end of it, what happened to our outcome? They are all in the library, they are all being cooked, you know, patented, copyrighted. Sorry. The public wants to read it, sorry. So there's something wrong here. So that's where UNESCO is now calling, hey, we should make public funded project outcome available. And this is where it comes up with this thing called open educational resources. And that is where open licensing comes in. Okay? So it says that open educational resources provide a strategic opportunity to improve the quality of education as well as facilitate policy dialogue, knowledge sharing and capacity building. Now, when we talk about Creative Commons, these are the symbols that you need to see. BY stands for attribution. Equal sign is no derivative. The share alike sign, and then non-commercial. What do they mean? If you see only, you know, the attribution sign, for example, if you go to Dr. Liu's book, which is available in actually our OER website, his book is just a BY. Which means you can use and you can copy and paste it into any of your publication, no problem. Don't inform me, no need to inform me. And that's Creative Commons. But you must cite my name. Okay, so that is BY. You must attribute. No derivative, if there's a no derivative, it means, hey, this is my photo, this is my piece of art. You can use it, but not allowed to change the color, not allowed to remodify. If it's a share alike, you see the symbol share alike. It simply means, yes, you can use it, you can copy it, you can edit it, no problem. But at the end of it, you must also use the same symbol, the Creative Commons symbol. Share the same Creative Commons licensing. Okay. And non-commercial, which means, you know, there's another book by Professor Charles up there in our OER center. You can use any of the pictures there, and they go underwater, you know, to take video. So using them, but do not publish into a book and you sell the book. So non-commercialization comes in. So up to us now to pick whichever we want. So because of this, we can come up with actually this 6 combination of licenses. So the first one is attribution only. And this is very free, you know. It means you're very charitable. Okay? Your heart is very big to share it freely. They just have to quote your name, cite you. Okay. And then we have the attribution and share alike, or attribution and the non-commercialization. The one that is in our smart UMS actually is using attribution and non-commercialization. And also the other combination. Now, over here, we can see that actually on the left-hand side, once again, public domain is one whereby if they list public domain PD there, it means use my material freely. No need to get permission from me, and you don't even have to cite my name. Now, where in the world can you find such a people? There are many of these wonderful people, okay? But normally, you know, out of courtesy, as Dr. Tan put it very nicely, you know, out of politeness, out of academic ethic, we at least mention, okay, cite who, where we get it from. So, the most free in all Creative Commons licenses is, of course, public domain. They also put a CC 0.0 there. Then, of course, the attribution, okay, share alike, non-commercialization, and then non-commercialization as well as share alike. Okay? The least free are down there. Not encouraged to come over here. Huh? The most important characteristic of Creative Commons materials is that if you see any symbols, you know, to do with any graphic or any video or any article, then it means you can use them, okay? According to these 5 characteristics, you can retain them. That means you can copy, download, clip into your laptop, and you can use it, okay, for future references, and even retain it and share it among your students, no problem, without any permission. You can reuse it, you can revise it, okay, all depending on, you know, what is the license that they've already given to their product. They can remix it. So out of Dr. Tan Jason was saying, you know, you get this and that and that, and then maybe you can remix them. Yes, Creative Commons graphic, you can do that. Okay, as long as they allow you to remix. So as long as there's no, the one that with the equal sign down there, you cannot edit them. Other than that, all the rest up there, you can take and remix them. Okay. And also, you can redistribute them. That's where, you know, we can put into our MOOC freely, clear conscience, no problem. Okay. So, these are the details again concerning the characteristic of all the different licenses, 6 of them. Okay. Let's have a look at this very short video. Okay, let's observe this video to get a clear understanding of Creative Commons within a few minutes.
Countless creative people and intellectuals that can inspire us with their writing, art, music, research, and discoveries. Such creativity is a treasure that should be shared with the world. A lot of creative people want to share their ideas so they can grow and develop. This piece of writing is brilliant. Can we work together? Wow! Can we sample your tune? Oh, look at this. I share your art on my blog. Oh, Jesus. Can I use your formula? The internet makes this possible, but strict copyright regulation sometimes gets in the way. Meet Creative Commons. Creative Commons encourages content creators to collaborate and share their work with others. This way, together, we can maximize the power of the internet, nurture a spirit of innovation, and encourage exchange of experiences and culture. Creative Commons offers a series of content rights licenses that are built on copyright laws. They spell out how you want your work attributed and shared, while still protecting your creative rights. What are the licenses? This sign attributes the work to its owner. How do you want to be known? This sign prevents the user from using their creative work for commercial purposes. This sign indicates that the user can use the work, but cannot apply any changes to it. No remixing. This sign gives the permission for modifying and distributing the creative content, but the user must share their work under the same terms as the original. Keep it moving forward. So how do you get a license for your work? Easy! Visit www.creativecommons.qa or creativecommons.org. Go to the licensing section and answer a few simple questions about how you want to share your work. Allow commercial users of your work? Allow modifications of your work? Select a license. Click Submit, and you'll generate a code for your license that you can easily apply to almost any digital work. Now your work can be shared openly, and you will have the confidence that rights are respected. You can even search for other works under Creative Commons. It's a worldwide community. Share your ideas for the whole world to discover them. Help unlock the massive potential within the Arab world, and share it with everyone. Creative Commons.
How common actually is Creative Commons? Okay. Let's have a look at some example. For example, if you go to Google and you just type a search, butterfly, example I put over here, you put search tool and then you got a label for reuse and modification. Yeah, over here. Okay. And you click on that, and this is what you have some option. So you can pick, you know, label for reuse and modification, label for reuse. More often than not, these are the Creative Commons materials. Flickr is one place that you can get good quality photograph. Now please remember that many people, you ask, you know, why in the world that millions of quality products are shared over here free of charge? Your guess is as good as mine, okay? Some of them is for the purpose of just promoting their name, promoting the scientist, promoting the company, maybe, or promoting the photographer himself. So for example, in Flickr, I just type Flickr and I just type Creative Commons. Look, the amount of materials under BY, high quality photograph, you know, over 72 million. Now, I don't know how many lifetime we need to go through every one of them. Attribution and non-derivative license, 21 million. Wow, 99 million. Non-commercial license, 50 million.
So, Prof, let's say you want to take all the, some of these pictures for
yes.
BY one.
Yes.
Can you share with them how to take the picture and also what to put?
And below the
okay.
picture.
There's a time. I figured that out. There's a question you will ask. So, example now over here. Dr. Tan's answer is here already. So let's say this is a photo that you use from Flickr, then you label it Flickr, let's say it's number 2. The name of the photo, some of them don't give names, you know, you give the name, it's okay. Then by, okay, the author, the year, from where, Flickr, and here it is through via media common. So exactly from where you get it, just mention it. And then under Creative Commons Attribution CC BY, this is version 2 at that time, okay, and put generic or international. And over here is your citation. It's like that, as simple as that. Now, the citation for Creative Commons is open, you know. It's not a standard format. But as long as, the most important is the name of the author, okay, and then where you get them from, or the title, digital image, some of that don't have, okay, and the website. This is the most important. Okay. As long as you put the website, people can click it and go and they can see actually the author's work.
For the purpose of our MOOC, we use this picture.
Correct.
For the picture in our slides,
correct.
We still have to write this creative.
Exactly. This will be our
this
for,
the citation.
Under reference.
That's why we say citation.
Citation.
Yeah, I mean, yes, yeah. Citation, we always do that. But the Creative Commons, it's a must now in the MOOC. This CC, this attribution CC BY, if we modify it.
Oh yes. So you got to see whether you can modify or not.
Modify it,
like for example here,
the picture,
CC BY only, that means you can modify it, you can change the color over here, you add something in, okay? But still you have to contribute from where you get it from, the original.
So this is the author. All the pictures in the slide that we are using in the MOOC, we really have to put that Creative Commons.
Yes, yes, yes.
But maybe you're trying to put it a bit corner.
You can just put it at the corner, of course.
I saw a lot of people just put this part only, source, then in bracket.
Yeah.
But still, it's better to cite this person's name.
The name I think is good.
Yeah, good enough. Some will put like that. Name, what year, bracket, then source. What is it? Good enough.
It's just a book already, you know?
Yeah.
The name of the photographer, the year.
Yeah.
Okay. Then here in this case, Flickr, not Flickr. Then the URL. I think the URL is important.
I think this is important. You know why? A lot of young lecturers they don't do this. Now a lot of people just take picture and put in only.
We get ourselves covered,
I think this must be educated, Maybe they also didn't know about that.
Yeah.
But no excuse, you know why? Those who already completed PhD must know this. Because I think your professor have already tell you cannot simply plagiarize anything, right?
Okay. So, if you click, for example, now this one over here, some rights reserved. Okay, when you click it, actually this is what you get. So even when you produce your very own and you want to license it as a Creative Commons licensing product, then you can also link to this particular one. This sigil, the certificate. Okay.
So that means our slides can have the Creative Commons.
Yes, we can. Yes.
This is called self-licensing.
Self-licensing.
Yeah, you license your own product. If you put it somewhere in the website, you license your own product so that people know what type of action they can take.
Yeah. Okay.
So in the MOOC, all our...
The MOOC, you don't have to put any Creative Commons thing because we put everything under our UMS MOOC. Under the UMS MOOC, I think, don't know, Dr. Yusuf, there's also a Creative Commons there. Yeah, already put. That's our general license.
For the slide, we don't have to put it.
No, but the citation, you still need to put. If you have taken any pictures.
Yeah. You know, a picture, and then give a title to it, and in bracket, the name of the photographer, the year, from where, the website. Should be good enough. This attribution, it's an attribution. Where can you get Creative Commons materials? Abundance of them, okay? So oercommons.org is one place. You can be an author to contribute. You can just go into this place. This one, Creative Commons search engine. This engine is to search only for Creative Commons materials. So for example, YouTube, you click it, all are Creative Commons materials. Flickr and whatever else. Okay. Very briefly concerning OER then, because OER are materials that are licensed under the Creative Commons or open licensing. Creative Commons is one of them. So once again, OER are any materials in any format. Now this is the website .org/choose. Is a place where you just answer some simple question. Allow adaptation to your work to be shared, yes or no. Okay. Allow commercial use of your work, yes or no. And once you click it, this will come up, it's generated for you. And that's it, you got it already. Just use it and paste it there. You can download and get materials and the proper way to set your work. But we can also now contribute to the world of OER. And also Creative Commons materials. So example, at the moment, we have two books that are there, okay? And this one was published way back in, what year was it? 2014, okay? And this is totally under just CC BY. This one, is limited. Because a lot of original photograph and video. So they, and this is the benefit is UMS. If there's bulletin that is available from your faculties, for example, Bonensis, from ITBC, all their past issues are here. An example, this one, okay, this is Internet Archive. So I made use of this system actually to record things just a few, 3 weeks ago. So you put it into YouTube, okay? And the idea of whether it accounts to our Weibull matrix and green matrix value is actually this one. Make sure that it's tweakable. Okay. So it must be the http://, then only you put No, this one at the moment you see. Okay. And the licensing here is Creative Commons.
Okay. Where do you put that HTTP code? You put in which section of the in the description of the video?
Oh, so
it's
this one.
By YouTube.
Yeah, in the YouTube, you go to Video Manager. Mm-hmm. Video Manager. Click the Video Manager.
Yeah, the Creator Studio.
The site. Yeah, the Creator.
Then where do you put that thing? In
so the moment you click it, then down there description. There's a box description.
You need to put in the.
You just put in whatever materials is there already.
Okay, the link.
Yeah, that's right.
And also for the license, you have to choose
standard. There's a standard YouTube license. And you
open.
Click that for Creative Commons.
Oh, you just select Creative Commons.
Our students' work.
Okay.
Yeah. You can also actually put them there. Oh, here is music. If you make use of any music, then probably one of the ways also to cite it. Yeah. Again. The name of the musician, the name of the song or the music, and then the website. Okay, so that's where, and this is actually my students' work at the gamification project. So they share it as part of the OER. And every one of their project actually is a contribution to the Weibull Matrix again. So as Dr. Tan put it, we have actually in many corners of UMS have been doing many different things actually to support our Weibull Matrix ranking. This is one course that you can go through. It takes about 2 hours, and you will really be able to master what is actually common as well as OER. This is created by actually.
You get your first certificate.
Yeah, and you get a certificate. You get a certificate, yeah. Okay. This is produced by Commonwealth of Learning. Okay, so ending, you know, with this book, The Tipping Point, one of my favorite books by Malcolm Gladwell. Is that magic moment when an idea, a trend, a social behavior crosses a threshold tip and spreads like wildfire. So we hope that the Creative Commons, the OER, the MOOC may achieve their tipping point. Okay.
Is this book about OER or just general? This book
general.
About everything.
Any product.
Phenomena.
Any product, you know, that can become spread like wildfire. Making the old one obsolete. The analog camera today. Obsolete.
Electric cars.
There you are. So moving forward, yes, we can consume them, okay, in many different places. But we, it's time also that, you know, we be bold and confident, and that we can also be a prosumer. That means consumer becoming a producer. That is the word prosumer. Other than that, I have some references that are available over here. We will share the PowerPoint. Okay. Any question?